the keynote speaker of this morning is Bokusala Irokoshima. Irokoshima graduated from Osaka University, where he was under the supervision of Shingo Nirakai. He received his PhD in 1970, and from then, he has been working at Yamaguchi University. At the present, it is emeritus professor. Another significant event of this moment is the presence of Professor Jean-Luc Kozo. I am honored to welcome Professor Kozo, the pioneer of SM Joint. Professor Kozo, on behalf of both organized and scientific committee of GSI, I am pleased and I have great pleasure to express our gratitude and to thank you for having accepted the honor by your presence, the first and the national conference in France on geometry, science of environment. Professor Shima, please start your talk on geometry of patients' doctrine.
I would like to express my thanks to organizing committee of GSI for giving me an opportunity of talking about geometry of patient structures. I am very glad to dedicate this lecture to Professor Kozo in honor of him. In 1964, Professor Kozo was sent to Japan by the French government and gave lecture at Osaka University. I was a student in those days and attending the lecture together with the late Professor Matsushima and Murakami. The topics of the lecture was theory of flat mantle with flat connection, D, and a closed one from alpha, such that D alpha is positive definite. Alpha being a closed one form, it is locally expressed by alpha equal D phi, and so D alpha equal dd phi is just a flexion method in a viewpoint. This is the ultimate origin of the notion of flexion algebra, flexion structure, and the starting point for my research. In this lecture, I surveyed the geometry of the shell structure. This is the contents of my talks. Hessian structures and Kalian structure. Dual Hessian structure. Hessian curvature tensor. Regular Forrest cone. Hessian structures and affine diffusion geometry. Hessian structures and information geometry. Invariant Hessian structure. Section 1. Hessian structure. We first define the notion of Hessian metric. A manifold with flat connection D is, let M be a manifold with flat connection D. A Riemann metric G on M is said to be a Hessian metric. If G can be locally expressed by G equal D D phi, the component G I Z equal delta phi over delta psi delta z. Where we use xi x n, an affine coordinate system with respect to D. The pair DG is called the Hessian structure. And the manifold M with Hessian structure is called a Hessian manifold. The function phi is the potential of the Hessian structure dg. Among many Riemannian metrics, that may exist on flat manifold M with flat connection D. The Hessian metrics are the most compatible with a flat structure, flat connection D. We explain this back in this lecture. Definition. Difference tensor gamma. This idea was obtained from Professor Koshu. Let gamma be the difference tensor between Levi-Civita connection lambda for G and the flat connection D. The component of the difference tensor gamma is K, equal large gamma ijk, where large gamma ijk is a Christoffel symbol for G. In general, large gamma ijk is not tensor, but the left-hand side is a tensor field. This idea is due to Professor Koshu. Proportion. Characterization of Hessian metric. Let MD be a flat manifold and G a Riemannian metric on M. Then the following conditions are equivalent. G is a Hessian metric. The second condition, D X G Y Z equal D, Y, G, X, Z. That is, the covariant tensor D, G is symmetric. This equation is called Kodachi equation. The condition 3. The third condition, G, gamma, X, Y, Z equal G, Y, gamma, X, Z. The second condition, the Kodachi equation suggests that a pair of a connection D not necessarily flat. And Riemannian metric G, and such a pair is called Kodaly structure. The study of Kodaly structure not so developed. A little result I obtained, but not so much. In the theory of Hessian structure, the difference tensor gamma plays an important role. Section 2. Hessian structures and Kaelian structures. Let us recall Kaelian method. A complex manifold with Hermitian metric G equals GRZ dz I dz bar z is called a Kaelian metric. If G is expressed by complex section, the component GRZ equals delta C over delta Z I delta Z bar Z, where Z1, Zn are holomorphic coordinate system. Therefore, both Hessian matrix and Kaelian matrix are similar, both in expressed by Hessian form, which differs only in their being real or complex. For this reason, Chen and Liao, called Hessian metric, are fine Kaelian metric. Hessian metric and Kaelian metrics are formally similar, not only formally similar, but also intimately related at all. Proportional. Let Tn be the tangent bundle over the Hessian manifold M. Then Tn is a complex manifold with Kaelian metric. We first explain that Tn is a complex manifold. We said Zi equals Xi plus square root minus 1 dxi. Xi is an affine coordinate system with respect to D on the Hessian manifold. Then Z1, Zn forms a holomorphic coordinate system on the tangent bundle. Therefore, tangent bundle has a canonical complex structure. Moreover, we define Gt equal sigma Giz dz I dz bar z, where GDI is a component of Hessian metric G. Then GD is well defined as Kaelian metric. Example, tangent bundle over paraboloid. Let omega be the standard paraboloid defined by the inequality. And let phi be a function phi or low defined on omega. Xn minus 1 half times sigma x squared inverse. This is a function of omega. And taking log, then the function of phi is positive definite. And so g equal to d d phi is a Hessian metric. Then, the tangent bound T omega is isomorphic to a two domain omega plus square root minus 1 in the complex space Cn. This two domain is holomorphically isomorphic by Kelly transform. By Kelly transform, the holomorphically isomorphic to the bounded domain Bn. Bn is an open unit box defined as inequality. Then, the canonical Kelly metric on the tangent bound is isomorphic to the Bergman metric on Bn. In general, bounding domain admit the Bergman metric. For the case n equal 1, omega is the half prime of positive numbers, and t omega is a half plane, the Poincaré half plane, and Bn is an open interval in complex Gaussian space C, Gaussian planes, and Gt is isometric to a Poincaré metric. Section 3, dual Hessian structure. Definition, gradient mapping. Let omega dg be a Hessian domain in Rn, and let alpha n be the dual vector space of Rn with standard flat connection d star. We define the gradient mapping yoga from omega to the dual space alpha n by the following. Iota x equal minus d phi equal minus del phi over del sum del phi over del ten. Then eta is an imaginary because the Jacobian of iota just coincides with a Hessian matrix, therefore regular, and eta is an imaginary from omega into r star n. Using this imaginary iota, we pull back the flat connection d star on r star n to the flat connection d dash on omega by the following equation, by this equation. Iota star d dash x1 equal d star iota star x iota star y. We call then d dash, of course, flat connection, and d dash is called the dual connection of d with respect to the Hessian metric G. The gradient, this gradient mapping play very important role in the theory of Hessian structure. This theorem is well known by Amari and Naoko and others. And let dg be a Hessian structure, and d dash the dual connection of d with respect to g. Then we have x, y, z equal g dxy z and plus gy d dash xz. And d dash equal 2 nabla minus d. The pair d dash d is also Hessian structure and is called the dual Hessian structure of dg. A potential of d dash d is given by the following Lujan transform phi. Amari Professor Mare Nagaoka calls the pair dd dash dually flat connection with respect to g. Historically, the notion of dual connection was obtained by quite different approaches. In affine differential geometry, the notion of dual connection was obtained by considering a pair of affine margins and its conormal margin. Another approach was done by information geometry. In this conference, Professor Amari will talk about the role of importance of the dual connection in information geometry. Theorem, dual Hessian structure, dual Hessian domain. Suppose that the gradient mapping yoga from omega to r sine is an embedding. And we say omega star equals iota omega, and phi star equals phi dash, the Lujan transform, phi dash iota inverse. And so g star equal d star d phi star. Then we have omega star g star d star is a Hessian domain and called the dual Hessian domain of omega dg. The gradient mapping yoga is an asymmetry from the Riemannian space omega g to the Riemannian space omega star g star. And identifying the dual space of our sign with Rn, we have iota star equal iota and phi star equal phi. That is, star operation is included. Section 4, Hessian curvature tensor definition. A tensor field Q of type 1-3 defined by Q equal D gamma. The component Qijk equal del gamma ij over direct k. This tensor Q is called the Hessian curvature tensor. The following equation was first obtained by Professor Matsushima. The Riemannian curvature tensor Rijk for G is expressed by Rijk equal half time Qijk minus Qjik. It's the first obtained by Professor Matsushima. we explain fossil forms. Let V be the volume element for Hessian metric G. Then the covariant derivative dxv of V in the direction x is a scalar multiple alpha x of V. Then alpha x is a real number. So alpha is a one form, and alpha is a closed one form. This form alpha is called the first possible form. The second possible form equal beta equal d alpha. The component is given by alpha I equal gamma R Ri. Beta I j equal Q R R I j. Here we use the Einstein summation convention. Let us consider an analogy of Riemannian sectional curvature using Hessian curvature tensor. For orthonormal unit tangent vector A and B, we said G equal Q A A B B equal Q I J K AI AJ BJ BK BL. This is called the Hessian curvature tensor for the tangent plane spanned by A and B. If all Hessian spherical curvature are constant C, we call the Hessian structure DG is a constant Hessian sectional curvature C. And this solution is equal to the following equation. Q I J K L equals CO2 G I J G K L plus G I L G K Z. This Hessian sectional curvature corresponds to holomorphic sectional curvature for Kirlian metric, rather than Riemannian sectional curvature for Hessian metric. Such a result conferred in the lecture note, theorem 3 or proposition 5 and 6. The following is a beautiful and famous result in Kirlian geometry. The compact Euclidean space Cn is constant holomorphic sectional curvature 0. The second,